slick tongue, creeping on your girl wrong. Like the government agency that hates the words of my creepy song. All up in your shit like a dirty ass thong. Got info from your garbage can all day long. Walking through the neighborhood with a laptop like the Secret Service. Know everything about you and I won't stop. Front door's unlocked, I'm hiding in your house. Quiet as a church mouse. I invade your privacy and I be on you. So man nasty like homemade rental class. Day one's helpless, you can watch me push. I'm the crib. I'm the crib.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Yes, thank you. Thank you.
Thank your motherfucking asses. I love this shit. Cultural nepotism. There's something wrong with the Long Beach Unified School District when it's subjugated by the budget cuts to public schools. Check it. The school district has slashed more than $330 million. From its budget and cut more than 1,000 jobs in the past 4 years in an effort to offset severe losses in state funding. School officials say they can no longer afford to fund certain operations such as middle school CSOs, campus security officers. Okay, do I have to remind people, okay? Batman, Columbine, Aurora, DC, fucking Maryland. Motherfuckers coming to school with guns because some stupid ass jerk wants to fucking, you know, tease a motherfucker. Alright, I hate to tell you, you know, that's a bloodshot in the motherfucking ass. Alright, okay. LBUSD spokesman Chris F. Chichow said that the school district will still have 63 CSOs, but its high schools this fall along with armed campus police officers. I don't know if these guys are going to have bazookas or what, but last year the Long Beach District School cut CSOs from its K through 8 school, sparking a protest and petition from Hudson K through 8 parents who said their campus security officers kept high school students from neighboring Cabrillo High from wandering onto the campus. Okay, what the fuck? I mean, what are high schoolers roaming around on a middle school campus for? Are these guys like becoming like, you know, future pedophiles, or is it just like gang members are looking for new people to bring in so they can fucking have those guys, cats killed? All right, that's called mushrooming, people. I mean, so Joanna Ramos died in vain to what is called a fiscal negligence. I mean, come on, right or wrong? Well, you can't blame the teachers on this one. Either that, or one can blatantly say that Superintendent Chris Steinhauser has his hands tied behind his back and is only a messenger that can't be killed because the state's budget woes and coming elections to pass new tax measures that don't even hit public schools in the slightest, right? Well, we got fucking money to build a damn super train, but no money for books, campus security, after-school electives, nor music, right? Whatever happened to the dormitory, you know, whatever happened to the donationary arm of the lottery winnings? Where's that money been going to, and why hasn't it offset any of these catastrophes as of yet? So what if there is a pragmatic prison-like atmosphere of schooling, and the prisoners are talking to the guards on the slide because the teachers and parents are nixed between culture and education? By cutting CSOs from the middle school population only means that whatever shit slips through the cracks usually winds up the future criminal element. And you think the police are undermanned now. Killer Cali, here we come.
Bloodshot. This is how it's going down with Ross Class. But I come and book up your shine and them a bloodshot. Neo niggas obsolete. Players if my thugs are the pit up, mister, to say the bloodshot. This is how it's going down with Ross Class. But I come and book up your sound. It's back to school, the first day is the worst. Boy conflict, forget about it. TV thugs wanna see who bitched up first. Take a guess who's next for the high school terrorist. For 3 months, views monster simmers. Popularity makes losers out of winners or sinners. But yeah, staff don't kill you. They'd rather suspend to jail send. Every day at every locker at lunch. You're the hacky sack of shit they kick. raised like a little bitch. Yeah, little nigga, you need a bloodshot. Bloodshot, this is how it's going down. With brass clad, but they come and broke up your sound. And then my bloodshot, Leo niggas obsolete. But players ain't my dogs, on the paint up my sleeve. I said,
oh yes, they are passing up by. Hey, Blacka Borka, Blacka Borka. Okay, this is a quote from Noam Chomsky. If you don't know, I suggest you find out quick. He quotes how much of a penal population we truly are. He says, quote, one out of every 32 adults in the United States was in prison, in jail, on probation, or out on parole at the end of 2005. American, with a population of 307 million, ranks first among all nations with 715 prisoners per 100,000 people. China, with a population over 1 billion, ranks 71st with 119 prisoners per 100,000 people. The United States is way ahead of the rest of the industrial world in imprisoning its own population. That's population control. None of it has anything to do with crime. So, I gotta ask you liberal motherfuckers out there and so forth, and all you right-wing, left-wing, dumbass motherfuckers, okay? Who in the fuck is trashing, okay? Who in the fuck is trashing this shit about, you know, in total hypocrisy about human rights abuse? Okay, the world will never fucking know, right? Hey, look at it this way. It's a recession-proof industry, niggas! Ha ha! Keep going off in my brain, all in my brain is nothing but a bitch thing, baby. Okay, we come to the butt end of our show here, and of course, you know, I always involve the audience in this and so forth, because you can always say this in the middle of a quiet crowd, even in an auditorium with whack musicians or whack rappers for that matter. I want you to breathe this in and say this with me. On one, on two. And on the Labor Day weekend, we will all go out and get fucked up on. On three, asshole of the day. Okay, when you do crime, always remember it's who it's done against and why one should never be so stoic and shy in meeting black motherfuckers in the first, like me in the first goddamn place, and making an assumption that I do crime. Bet. But sure as shit, you fucking trust Whitey for fucking get over, alright? And this nigga will fuck you very long time. Kamikaze Toko Tai, bitches, check it. The Japanese American Cultural and Community Center announced President Greg Willis, Shay Whitey, okay? Super, the number one running cracker, alright? Sudden resignation last week after revelations that Willis
had been convicted and sentenced for misuse of funds at a previous job in France. Evelyn Yoshimura, the center's community organizing director, says she had doubts about Willis from the beginning, but because he had no connection to Japanese Americans and no experience in nonprofits or art organizations whatsoever. Questions remain about why the organization hired Willis in the first place, especially since details about his criminal past are just a Google search away. Willis is believed to be on the run, wanted by French authorities for misappropriation and misuse of corporate money and other criminal convictions. Alright, what the fuck, okay? You're still afraid of the Coco Gene, but after getting H-bombed twice and herded into American concentration camps, motherfuckers would trust a gaijin to continuously fuck them over, even in complete embarrassment? What's that? No comment? Of course, Greg Willis was a con artist from the start. Okay, no, you can say it now. Elvis has left the fucking building and is probably on his way to the Philippines, where criminal extradition is hard to come by. Especially if France wants him first. So, how much money did he get? Thousands? Millions? Who knows? But one thing's for sure, he got you and got the fuck out of Dodge, okay? Best thing is for the Yakuza to do is to go find this mangy bastard and do him good, or send him back in little pieces. Think about it. This motherfucker is on the run on some white flight catch me if you can bitch shit. And to think, he got away with causing such dishonor. I have to smile, especially when you already had a case against brothers like me who don't fucking karaoke so well. Hey, I suck at it. I honestly confess that. I suck at it. Okay? But I can still rap, damn it. Okay? Yeah, you had a ghost face killer among your ranks, and even when I look up any additional information, like a ninja, this motherfucker is ghost. He fucking deleted his Twitter accounts, all his shit. Facebook account gone, okay? Let's just say JACCC got pimped, tricked, and sipped by the slickest asshole of the day. And I'm telling you right now, DB Cooper, one of the luckiest motherfuckers who got away with shit, is probably fucking laughing from his grave on this one, I'm sure. Think about it. I'm eating a bowl of rice. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's right. Where are all the white women at? Anyway, if you missed it, hey, this is the wrap up. If you missed it, then play it again until you fucking get it. You can do all that shit. Anyway, you can say moving forward like a bitch all day, but know that I'm ahead of your bullshit. Okay? This has been your radio show, and of course, yours truly, that Bust That Ass Radio 83.17 FMX, and the X stands for You Don't See Me Coming When You Never Saw Where I've Been At, all up in your ass. Steady shellacking the pom pom, running that shit harder than ever. Booty bubbles ahoy! And I will see you in the motherfucking street, bitches. Take flight. Oh, hey, and on the Labor Day weekend, check it. I will be out of town till fucking Tuesday. So Monday show has been preempted. So eat an egg, bitch. Ha ha ha! That's right. Fucking punk motherfucking shit. I love it!